Dear viewers of the Tom Photo channel, many of us photography enthusiasts have returned from a photo shoot only to discover, after downloading the photos, that there was dust on the sensor, resulting in an unsightly blob in the photo, most commonly in the sky or some other smooth region. Fortunately, this is usually not a problem, and the solutions are quick and easy. If you haven't already, please download GIMP. The link is down in the text box. GIMP is a free photo editing tool that offers a wide range of features, including dust removal. To get started, open GIMP and load your photo. The best way to remove dust is to use the Heal tool. You may have an icon for it, but since all interfaces can be configured differently, the surest way to find it is to navigate to Tools, Paint Tools, and Heal. You will see a circle, and this circle should be larger than the dust image on the photo. Refer to the menu on the left of my interface. Adjust the circle's size until it covers the dust particle adequately. Additionally, increase the hardness to a value greater than the default setting. The ideal hardness may vary, but I found that for effective dust removal, a value of at least 98% works well. However, this may depend on your specific photo and the intensity of the spot. Now, position the circle right next to the dust spot, ensuring that no part of the dust spot is covered. Ensure that the color and texture of the area where you place the circle closely match the area with the dust spot. Then hold down the control key and click your mouse to record the info for dust spot removal. Next, you will need to paste this over the dust spot. Move the circle to fully cover the dust spot and simply click with your mouse. Like magic, the dust will disappear. If you're not satisfied with the result, try adjusting the circle's hardness or copying from a different location. Another method for removing dust involves using the clone stamp function. Go to Tools, Paint Tools, and Clone. However, please note that this method is not as effective as the Heal tool. The clone function simply copies an area from one region and places it on top of another. In contrast, the Heal function is more intelligent and takes into account the gradients and color schemes of the region you're trying to correct. Thank you for your time. I hope you found this video tutorial helpful, and I encourage you to consider subscribing to my channel and giving it a thumbs up. Enjoy your photography and say goodbye to those pesky dust spots. Goodbye.